Welcome to the Go Ham Show. I'm DJ Go Ham, and tonight we are watching Scar-Lord. Oink, oink, pig, pig, do away with the pork. Now, Scar-Lord was amongst the many artists that I posted on my first poll on my community forum that suddenly unlocked once I got over 1,000K subscribers. Give you guys a round of applause. Not bad for somebody who doesn't really beg for freaking subscribers every single video. The point is, I wanted to see what you guys actually wanted to see me do next, and out of everybody, I thought everybody would have chose X, but you guys chose Scar-Lord, and he dropped a freaking album last Friday, but I'm gonna be honest with you, I wanna just look at his stuff that I've seen already, and I know that you guys probably know about his backstory, but I'll explain it as we watch the video. But before we get started, I will give this dank hit a nice review because it needs to invest my soul with its proper juices and enrich me with 5 stars. I feel like IMDb incubating reviews. Ooh. That's me sucking back in the smoke really fast. I don't want it to leave. Anyway, let's pull up the video. I don't know none of these animes, but I know that Scar-Lord is hype as fuck. They say this man is the one who kind of like pumped in more juice into trap metal, or the combination of freaking loud distorted 808s over loud yelling. But I'm just gonna be honest with you, as long as we got tracks that have like guitars, freaking distortion, and hard aggression, it doesn't even need to be something on this caliber. It just needs to be something really, really hype. Oh wait, I know the show, wait a second, somebody, yo, check this out. I was like, yo, what the fuck, this kid, I was like, yo man, anime is so cool, because this kid ain't really a kid. I was like, yo man, what the fuck, this kid is awesome. And then you guys are like, no, this kid ain't no motherfucker, he's like a 300-year-old demon that summons vampires out of his face. Oh no, this is some anime shit. See, now Scar-Lord was a man who once had a career doing YouTube videos, and he had to, you know, live in a padded room like this all the time and record and look happy all the time. It's quite exhausting mentally. However, in his case, he has now taken the liberty to unleash his anger on his music, and his music has gotten him now known across the world. Not bad for a British man. Now, when he said bleed, but it's not like he's saying brood. That's like an X-Men supervillain. So far, I at least seen at least 3 different animes, and like the scarier ones always gotta like have like really, really gory deaths. But a lot of people like seeing the splatterhouse like type of animes, and where they're just like killing things and blood is going everywhere. I don't know why people like that, but maybe that's just part of the animation and it makes it more gory and shit, and it goes with the music better. I'm not helping anyone, but take a chance, little prince. See, now, you guys also notice how freaking Scar-Lord is able to jump back and forth from, like, a dope-ass swag flow, triplets, and then jump right back into just yelling and yelling. Like, he is seamless with this without coming off as corny or without coming off as too aggressive. Like, it's, like, perfect. Just some of his music is being purchased by the WWF and WWE. Whatever they're called now, just the Wrestling Federation wants to actually use his music. And that is a great thing to see, that freaking trap metal or this type of aggressive music that I like to categorize as dank music. I really like to think of it as a great thing, because then you could use this music towards fight music such as boxing matches between YouTubers. But who would ever think of that would take off ever again? Like, that might be like a fad. This is what you do after you, like, stomp your toe when you're about to go to sleep at night and you, like, hit it right on the edge of the bed. You just go, fuck, 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 fuck. Come on, right?
So sorry. That right there is a mental breakdown on the track. My bad. For that shit, they dig and shed it. I don't give a fuck. All these presents keep my gap until I spill it. I've exceeded expectations and I'm 25.
See, now the thing is, though, I really should be watching his videos, because, like, his image is something that I'm actually not showing, but I'll pull up a quick image. But he wears a mask and a lot of dark clothing because he wants to conceal his face to hide his old YouTube identity so people could just know him for his artwork. Or for his art and work. But the point is, this man actually wants to be concealed so he can create the illusion of probably yelling on the mic. And he's probably not even doing that at his concerts and whatnot. But you know what, man? That's what's dope about it. Like, you can get away with having that image and people can draw you little art. And then you can just use that and put that on, like, freaking book bags and shit. And sell that and you go older and none of that art ever does. So it all works out in the end. I want some brute. I want a brood witch. A brood witch from... Oh, wait. I forgot. I put this on loop. Oh, yeah. But the point is, this was an amazing track, and it made me want a brood witch. And by a brood witch, I mean a sandwich. A very delicious sandwich from Aqua Teen Hunger Force. When you eat it, you go to hell. But I'm not going to hell. But I am finna eat me a big-ass sandwich!